Welcome to the No Guilt Mom Podcast. I am your host, Joanne Crone, joined here by my co-host, Bree Tucker.
Well, hello, hello, buddy. How are you?
And if you're watching us on YouTube, you really saw my fancy dance motion to do that, to intro Bree. So and highly recommend.
And they get to see my awkward trying to figure out if I look at the camera or do I look at the mic or do I look at the notes.
We're getting it. We're totally getting it. But today we are talking about all the holiday stress, particularly how to stop comparing ourselves to others during the holidays.
Because you always end up walking away feeling like crap.
You do. You end up feeling like crap because you didn't do something that your neighbor did or your friend did or your sister did or so your mother-in-law did. I can go on.
Yes. So that means that you're not as good of a mom. You're not as good of a wife. You're not as good of a friend. You're not as good as a sister, as a daughter. Like the list goes on because – no matter what, you're never going to be the perfect ideal of everybody else. So there's going to be something that's going to make you feel like crap.
Yes. And we did an episode actually about the gap and the gain. It's really in that gap. So if you go and listen to that episode, it's a quick practice on positivity.
Yeah.
Totally listen to that about the mindset.
But I'll have a link in the show notes.
Awesome. So I was really interested about the story that you told of like in your family about the apologizing for things.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah. So kind of what sort of sparked this is that, okay, guys, I am 43. Mom, I love you. I know you listen to the podcast, but my mom still is apologizing to me for all the things that she didn't do with me because she stayed at home with my sisters until they were in school. And when I started school, she went back to work. Mm. And so my mom's like, oh, I didn't do breakfasts with you. And I didn't do that. I'm like, dude, I have a lifetime of amazing memories. The crap that you're thinking that you were a bad mom and that I lost out on, I didn't even faze me.
No, it's funny because, mom, I love you too. And I get the apologies as well about looking at things I do with my kids, which I don't really think are that spectacular at all. Like, because I mean, I think that's just how you look at your own parenting. You look at the stuff you do and you're like, whatever. And then you look at the stuff other people do and like, oh my gosh, if only I could be like that.
Yeah.
And I think that's why we need this episode because my mom looks at me and she's like, I'm sorry, I was not a good mom to you. And I'm like, mom, no, it was wonderful. It was wonderful.
And it's true. I think that no matter how healthy you are, that shame and that guilt creeps in because we have a world where we're connected to each other so much. We can see everything that everybody else is doing. I have a Pinterest board just called cool ideas of like crap that I want to do that I will never get around to doing because there aren't enough hours in the day.
Yeah. So we are going to go down how you could stop comparing yourself to others this holiday. We're going to be talking about the actual things to let go of. And Bree and I prepared for this episode really well. And if you, again, are on YouTube, we have a list.
Yes, we do. We do.
We have lists.
At some point, we're going to have a pause.
So stay tuned for the phase you can stop comparing yourself to others this holiday season. And now on with the show. Okay. So here at No Guilt Mom, Bree, well, we're very into setting timers and making brain dumps and lists. We do this in a Balanced VIP group every week with our time blocking with our members. And so in brainstorming this episode, Bree's like, okay, I'm going to put the music on for a minute and I want you to write down everything that you feel like you are responsible for this holiday season.
Because I think it's tricky like that, right? Like I think anytime anybody asks me what I'm responsible for, and you'll know this from working with me, I kind of get this deer in headlights look and I'm like, oh my gosh, I got to remember everything. Because if I say too little, people are going to be like, you're lazy and you don't do stuff. I try to make sure I list it all. So we wrote it down because I know this is one. Holidays, I know I've got a lot of expectations.
It's so funny. So a little aside, whenever I ask you that question, there's always an ulterior motive that I think you are doing too much.
I'm always like, I got to make myself worthy.
I'm always like, I think you're doing too much.
I can't be the only person that feels like that.
No, I don't think you are.
Somebody asks, you're like, ah.
Yes. Yeah. So we have them down. Yes. We have them down. So I think you should go first.
Okay. So the question we asked each other was, what do you feel like you're expected to do this holiday season? Mm-hmm. And so for me, I reflected on all the things that are in my head that I'm expected to do. Buy presents for both families, coordinate with my ex-husband and my family for social gatherings.
Which
during
is crazy all on its own.
during the holiday season. I need to wrap, and that includes buying all the wrapping supplies. Like if we're short on something, it seems to be like I'm the only one that notices that we are out of, you know, gift bags. Then I have to do it all. Then I have to hide the gifts because I just told you, like, we have had incidents where gifts got hidden and forgotten. So we've decided that Bree has to be in charge of that.
You know what? When you told me this the first time, I was like, why are you hiding gifts? And then I realized, oh, so people don't find them before Christmas because Santa Claus comes? Is that it?
Yes.
Or before they're wrapped?
before they're wrapped.
Before they're wrapped.
I don't have time to do it in the moment. I always have a holiday party, ugly sweater / cookie exchange / Drake exchange party. And that includes budgeting, doing all the shopping for it, calendar, finding a date on the calendar that the people that I've got to have there can make it. And then cleaning the house, which isn't even an issue. Like this year we're renovating, like we're redecorating, redoing our bathroom.
That's a lot.
Our kitchen sink.
Yeah.
Just so it's done before the party. So.
Oh my God. And the party is great. I've won awards.
It's a fun party. I like the party.
I'm an award-winning party goer.
You are. And then my family likes to do family vacations, it seems like, over Christmas break, extended family. Food, so that I don't have to do cooking during the week of Christmas. Mm-hmm. I like to just have everything there, quick, warm up, instant food. Cookies, nobody will help me do cookies. And that was like a memory with my mom that I had. Oh. So like I have to cook cookies. It's like
there's an emotional tie in there.
Yeah, that I have to do it, but then I get better while I'm doing it because nobody will help me.
Oh my gosh, idea. Did you tell would your mom bake cookies with you? You could be like, maybe. Mom, you can make up for this horrible Christmas I had as a child. It is so mean. I'm sorry. You know, it's my humor.
Yeah. You know what's funny? We all do it. And yeah. We all make it to like my two sisters and my mom and I, we all make cookies at our own house. And then we all bring them over to my mom's house on Christmas Eve. Oh. And then my mom is constantly like, do not leave all these cookies here. Oh. You guys cannot leave like 4 dozen cookies at my house. But anyway. And then my mom also started a tradition when my mom and my dad, when I was younger, where they made this like homemade advent calendar that you do activities instead of candies.
Oh, that's cute.
25 days of it.
You do this.
You thought it would be easier when I got divorced than when he had the kids half of the time, but nope.
Oh my goodness.
So I have to come up with all the activities. Miguel tries to help.
Yeah.
But I feel like a lot of it is still on me. And then also buying all the things that are coordinated with it. So like say one thing that they've enjoyed doing on the advent, like we'll have one where it's crazy sculpture night. So first year we made sculptures out of margarine. And whoever won got a gift card. Last year, we made them out of Oreos. We each had our own pack of Oreos, and we had like 30 minutes to build something. And
that's fun. It's like a minute to win it.
Yeah.
Almost, but yeah. Longer time.
But I have teens, so the prizes are gift cards. So then I got to go out and buy the gift cards, and I also had to go out and buy the Oreos or the margarine, whatever it is, right? You had to buy all the supplies.
That is a really, really fun activity that I think so one thing that we've done in the past, like our group of friends, this was a long time ago. So not our current group of friends, but like my husband's group of friends. Anyways, long story. We had a Chopped night.
Ooh.
Where you didn't have to buy anything. We was at one person's house and you could use whatever was in their pantry to make the stuff. And of course, some things were off limits and everything. Like they were aware this was happening before. It was so much fun. And I love hearing that because I love hearing the margarine thing because I think I would be like, okay, let's make sculptures out of anything we have.
Ooh.
Yeah, but I like that idea.
Yeah.
That's fun.
It was fun, but it's a mess. So that's my short list of everything that I know I've got to do. And I didn't even add on there holiday activities that I want to go do.
Yeah.
Right?
Like, so you didn't even put in your joy.
Yeah. I want to go to Botanical Gardens because I love going there at Christmas time. And don't tap it down.
But anyway, okay.
What's yours?
So I had to go back to a few Christmases ago, 2019, where I was sitting on the couch crying on Christmas. And I'm like, this has got to stop because I was putting way too many expectations on myself and trying to continue things that I didn't even like doing. I felt like I had to do it too because it was like my childhood and I wanted to give my kids that kind of childhood. And then they didn't even really appreciate it as much as I think they should appreciate it. Do you know what I mean?
Yes, that's it. That's another toxic thing we have, right? The whole like nobody appreciates it to the quality that it needs to be appreciated.
Mm-hmm.
But half of the time though, we don't even know that they're like, dude, I do appreciate it.
We have a hard time like giving those things up. And I think we just pile on more and more and more to us. So the things that I was really putting on myself was the buying and deciding of gifts. And all of these like on their own, I think I would be totally fine taking like one or two of them. I think that all of them together is what really caused my breakdown.
It's like the deck of cards.
Yeah. It was in the wrapping of presents, holiday meal decisions, like what we were eating and planning, all of that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Coordinating and accepting invitations to all of the family holiday activities. I mean,
I forgot about that one.
It's the calendar. It's the schedule keeper.
You are the activities coordinator.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can make your head explode.
It does.
Decorating, I hate it with a passion. I'm sorry.
I forgot about that one too.
I'm sorry, whoever I offended. I probably offended my daughter, who runs actually a Christmas Instagram account, by the way.
Just let her be the one who does the decorating.
That's what we say. And she's like, I don't want to do it alone. I'll be like, I'll be there watching.
you just take 20 minutes to figure out where to put that one gnome.
Yeah.
And why she does the rest.
Yes, I do. I just don't like decorating. That's what you
should do. Walk around, just be like, oh, I'm not sure where to put it yet. Oh, okay. Oh, I love what you did that way.
I really appreciate having something decorated, but I do not enjoy the process at all. It stresses me out. You can
hire people for that, by the way.
I know. I was like, can I hire someone?
There's a girl named Bianca that does it here in your neighborhood.
Oh, interesting.
I've seen her.
I see that. Mm-hmm. This is a weird one. Giving acquaintance gifts, like those people you're friendly with throughout the year that like, oh, I'm going to spread Christmas joy and make you a plate of cookies and give everyone a plate of cookies. Because that's what's needed to be a kind and happy person. And how I say that kind of like with a little edge in my voice.
You're the gatekeeper. You have to figure out who to do it to and then what to give them because they're an acquaintance. It's not like a good friend. You don't necessarily know.
Well, it's funny because it comes under the keeping of relationships, which I think is so like not valued as something that needs to be done to function in society. Yep. I was talking with my husband and thankfully he's now seeing the value in it because he's like, yeah, I just wouldn't talk to anybody. And he's like, but I really like that you do, else we would have no friends.
Like, he enjoys the parties.
It's true. We would have no friends.
he's very fun at parties.
He is. He enjoys the people he likes to be around.
Yeah.
But he will not reach out to acquaintances or try to be friendly with neighbors or anything. Like a hey. But no, nothing goes deeper than that. Yeah. And I'm the one who's like, hey, are you my friend? Are you my people? Can I invite you somewhere? Like,
let's hang out.
That's very much me. It used to be holiday cards, thinking we needed a family holiday card. And I scratched that.
That is another one that I think a lot of people, I mean, if it brings you joy, great. But if it stresses you out, dude, let it go.
Let it go.
Save the earth.
Yes.
save the paper.
And then when I was a kid, one of my favorite Christmas memories was waking up and having our stockings full and being like, oh my gosh, what's in our stockings?
I didn't write stockings down.
I totally hate shopping for stockings.
So do I.
I think it's filled with, I'm sorry, I'm going to be very plain here. It is filled with the most useless junk that has like sugar and toys and things that go in the trash anyway. So you're like creating a waste for the environment. It was this whole thing.
Isn't it also easier though when they're little?
Yeah,
because when they're little, you can go get like little tchotchkes from like Dollar Tree or whatever and that throw some candy in there. They're good. You got a 15-year-old. Oh, this isn't from Bath & Body Works, Mom. I don't like this scent. You can take it back.
And I hope that you hearing us say these things are giving you permission to let it go.
Yes.
So let's talk about the kind of things that you can let go of this holiday season without feeling that you are less than because somebody is doing something different.
Yeah.
First of all, the type of gifts you give.
Yes. Okay. Again, I love you, Mom, but listen to me on this one. Gift cards are okay. They are okay. Please don't try to figure out my teen. I can't figure out my teen and I live with her.
It's so true. It is so true.
You realize how often I have to ask them, like, what is your size right now? Because you're going through growth spurts all the time. And they're like, I don't know. Mm-hmm. I'm like, size, style, whatever. Just gift cards work. Yep. Found a new thing. Snappy. Love Snappy.
Yeah. And cool like idea. With the gifts. So I feel like I have been putting this expectation on myself that I need to go get these perfect gifts for every child in our family, as well as the adults, as well as friends. And it's something that I don't even value. Like, I don't value stuff, as you know about me.
Yeah, you're definitely not a don't give me things. You're an experiences kind of person.
I am totally an experience person. So I think this year, instead of getting gifts for my nephews, I think I want to take them somewhere, like just somewhere in the valley, like a fun place that we can like all spend time together at, because I think that memory will last. And the gifts sometimes don't last. I mean, they're fun to open, and I bet I will give them something to open, like a picture of the place or something. But that I'm going to let go of, the giving of actual physical gifts this holiday season. I just said it out loud and now I'm like, oh, I'm a little scared about that. But yeah.
Yeah. I think that's an amazing, I love that idea. Like, again, experiences I think are a really great thing. And that's where like I get hung up. And I think a lot of people do get hung up. Like the whole, well, I got, and the other thing too with the gifts, who has gotten themselves stuck with the whole like, well, I have 5 gifts for this kid. I need to get 5. I only have 3 for this one. Granted, the 3 are worth the same amount this is, but now what do I do? Like, and your head's going to explode because you're like, do I go with numbers or do I go with value? I don't know. And it just, it ends up being so stressful. And so again, that's where like letting go of that stress, have a rule, like 1 gift per person, or maybe like you just said, it's experiences this year. I'm going to take you somewhere and do something. I know that would mean a lot more to my parents. Ooh. They would much rather go and spend a day with me than have a gift basket full of little things.
That's true. I think I'm going to do it for my parents as well, because yeah, like shopping for them, I want to show them that they are appreciated and cared for and I really love them. I've been feeling really pressured about the physical gifts and feel like I never hit the mark ever. And maybe it's just the physical gifts and I just need to change it a little bit.
And it gets like, and you know, going into extended family, this is something we did in our extended family that really helped my bank account because there's like 15 of us here in town. When it comes to the adults, we don't give gifts to each other. Mm-hmm. We do a gift exchange. Mm-hmm. So like we have a white elephant gift exchange and it makes it so much easier.
And it's really hard sometimes guilt-wise when you have, because we have that on mm-hmm. one side of my family. And we have this understanding, and then you come to the holidays and you find out that somebody has not done that understanding and has bought you a gift anyways. And then you're like,
but, we are freeing you of that guilt.
Yes, we're freeing you of it because you know what? You were upfront. You came to the understanding. They are the one who didn't respect it. You are not expected to get a gift because you were very clear.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
And okay. No apologies. Like, I didn't get you anything. Needed. Be like, no. Oh my gosh, thank you so much. And then enjoy your gift.
The fact that you're together for the holidays is what works.
Exactly. So,
okay.
Exactly.
Number 2, this was a big one. Okay.
Talking about holiday meals.
Yes. So there's a lot of ways you can skip on this one. I'm going to start with like, I love everybody in my life for sure. But my friend Jen used to always give me so much crap because when I would cook a homemade meal, it was with instant mashed potatoes, like a cut, slice, and heat ham already cooked all the way, you know, and like I had my can of peas, whatever. And to me, that was a home cooked meal. I put it all together. It's all there. And I would make dessert. And like, oh, I know that was it. One time I was supposed to go over to her house and I was supposed to bring dessert. Uh-huh. And so I had like 6 boxes of instant desserts. And I'm like, pick one. And she starts laughing. She's like, could you make a cake from scratch if you had to? And I'm like, well, I could, but why?
Why? If you're not, if you don't enjoy that sort of thing, right. The results are there. You said dessert. I say, here's a dessert.
Right. It works well. So anyways, my point is like, however you need to do those meals is totally fine. I loved your idea though for meals.
The meals, takeout.
How to cut on meals. Yes.
Takeout with DoorDash. And another idea we had is that a few years ago, it was actually before my daughter was born, mm-hmm. we took a big trip to London as like an entire extended family. So it was my in-laws, it was my parents, it was my sister. And we were there over Thanksgiving. And London, of course, doesn't celebrate American Thanksgiving. And so we were here wanting a meal together. And we found this cafe. You're going to love the name of this cafe. The S&M Cafe. That I went to with my entire family. And it wasn't like that. It was actually very homey and nice. And it stand for Sausage and Mash Cafe. And so it was like...
It's mashed potatoes?
Yeah, mashed potatoes. Okay. So it was like bratwurst style and then mashed potatoes. And it was just very homey and good. And that is something that for Thanksgiving, my husband and I did this pandemic times. We just went to a cabin in Flagstaff and we had sausage and mashed potatoes on Thanksgiving. And it was the most wonderful thing ever. And it was so easy to make. And so that is something that we replaced kind of the holiday meal with.
Yeah. Start a new tradition that is just yours. That's simple.
That's simple.
That you can pass on to your kids so that they don't have the guilt 30 years from now.
And don't feel like you need to make a holiday meal either. Like sometimes another thing my family did is on Christmas Day, we would tamales, like the pre-made tamales. Because we're here in the Southwest. So you can order those pretty easily, like frozen or freshly made. A lot of restaurants have them.
We had a lady that used to walk around our neighborhood and knock on your door.
Ooh, like, those sound good.
I saw tamale. You went
there. They're all like homemade. Oh my gosh, it's so delicious. But getting something like that that's really easy to cook for a lot of people, you put it like in a steamer, bam, done. So you don't have to cook a meal.
Right? I know. I think if that is something that everybody contributes to, and I do mean everybody needs to contribute to this, like get potluck style people.
Yeah.
Then maybe that's okay. But if it is stressing you out, let this go, man. Let it go. Let it go.
And these are all ideas that you could put into practice. But I think something we do really need to cover is that it is not totally on you to do the holidays. Like these are discussions that you could start having right now with your parenting partner or the other adult in the house, if there is one, because not everything should be on you.
Right. Exactly. Or even your kids. Or there are things that your kids can do. Like when I was younger, it was my job to do all the holiday wrapping.
Yeah.
Maybe that's why I get so bitter about it now. Like, by the way, all gifts, if you haven't noticed, from me always come in a gift bag because I was forced to do all the wrapping when I was little.
I don't like wrapping either.
God bless my dad. He was nice about it. He would just be like, hey, I'm at work and you're off from school. Do you mind like wrapping the presents for your mom? I haven't gotten around to them yet, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
And 1 year I had to wrap gifts and there was a rainbow unicorn t-shirt. And I was like 8 and I'm like, Dad, are you sure these are all moms? Yep. All moms. All of them. Yep. And Christmas morning, my mom unwraps it and she's like, Michael, did you have Brie wrap the gift?
Oh, no. Well,
this is yours, honey. I'm like, oh, good. I was wondering why you were like in your 30s and wanted a unicorn rainbow t-shirt
Oh, my goodness. Oh,
but anyways, my point is there are things that other people can do in the house. Have the kids like be like, hey, it is your job to wrap your own gifts.
And here's your gifts, wrap your own gifts. No, the gifts they give.
Oh, yes, the gifts that they give. Yes. That's what I mean.
Yeah, I know.
Sorry. Yeah. Yeah, that would be weird the other way.
My 13-year-old actually wrapped a lot of the gifts last year, which is great because she's very good at it.
Miguel is starting to take it over because he doesn't love the way I wrap gifts.
And
he does like perfect edges and he gets like the big fluffy bows that I have no patience for.
Yeah.
No patience for.
Can we talk a little bit about making our partners definitely more accountable in the process? Because I think a lot of the language that goes on, especially when we hear it in our coaching sessions and everything, is that, he doesn't like this or he doesn't want to do this. And it's being very considerate of our partner's feelings, almost to a detriment because it puts more work on ourselves.
We sacrifice ourselves for their happiness.
We sacrifice ourselves. And sometimes we're not even sacrificing ourselves for their happiness. We're sacrificing ourselves for no reason because we won't bring the discussion up. We assume it.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. We assume so that was another thing too. Like that list that I made up, these were all the things that I assume I'm in charge of. And I'm willing to bet that if I sat down and did this activity, you know what? I'm going to do it tonight with my husband. So Miguel, when you hear this episode, it's already happened.
It's already happened.
But we're going to sit down and do this. And I'm willing to bet you that he's going to have half of the stuff on his list too, because he's going to be like, I can do it.
Yeah, because something that we talk about, we just did a quick win on this in our Balanced VIP group about delegating and what it really means to delegate, because
that's hard.
So often we think delegating is like, hey, it's going to be so much work because then I have to make a list that tells them exactly what to do.
Yep.
And then I have to come in and if they don't do it right, that's not delegating. Delegating would be like saying like, hey, you're in charge of wrapping presents.
Here you go.
Know,
and if the presents come out in a brown paper sack that says fries on the side of it and like toilet paper stuffed inside instead of tissue paper, that is what that got done.
Well, and that's a discussion you could have too about like
of expectation.
Yeah,
imagine the memories.
The memories,
of the Christmas
yes.
where everything came in grocery bags with toilet paper.
Yeah, and it's something to keep in mind because I mean, when you delegate a task to somebody else, there's a lot of creativity there and like ideas that they come up with that you'd never thought of. And it's so fun to see because how different people's brains work. But you have to define if you're very particular about the gifts, just like about, so how should the gifts be wrapped? Is gift bags okay? And have that be a discussion instead of a one way.
Well, I think a big way to even start it a lot of times is, do you have any questions? Or something that we've taught the group to do, you know, if you really have like young kids and you're delegating to them, maybe you need to do this with your spouse as well, parenting partner at home. I don't know. But the whole I do, we do, you do path is super helpful too.
Yeah. I even don't think we need that with partners. Like,
it
gets to me.
You shouldn't have to. That's kind of talking down.
It's so funny.
You shouldn't have to.
It's so funny because I talk with my husband about this and he's like, why do some men have to be such man children? And these are his words. These are his words. Like I'm not, and I respect him for that because it shouldn't like have to be that way.
Yeah.
They are equal. They are an adult. They are adults. They're adults. And I get angry when some men kind of play into that a little bit. I've seen it happen.
Yeah.
And we get total pushback from that. And that's totally cool. Like against me about saying like how your husband or partner can't do anything like that. I want to challenge you on that one.
Well, and I think sometimes you have to think about where you're coming from, right? I don't want to dive into this too much because I know we're coming near the end of the episode. But I do think that it may be coming from a place of a good spot in your heart, right? Like you feel like, oh, I'm giving them the information. I'm helping them so that they can do it right. Or they can do it the way that it needs to be done. granted, there's a lot wrong with what I just said, but things can be done differently. They don't have to be done just the way you've read it in your head, but you're thinking you're helping them out by showing them how to do it step by step. You don't know what's going on in their head. Mm-hmm. They might be thinking, wow, you really think I'm an idiot because like you're just talking, or oh, wow, I really am incapable. I can't figure out how to do this without a step-by-step instruction.
And it's a complicated situation to unravel because I really feel like we've been programmed almost as women. And when I say programmed, it means like the media we watch, the Instagrams we see, the everything, like that stuff gets in your head. Yeah. It gets in your head about what a good wife is. It gets in your head about what a good mom is. And it happens not unintentionally, but unconsciously.
Yeah.
Like you don't realize it lives there until somebody comes and challenges it directly.
And then you're like, oh, snap.
And you're like, that lives in my head. Oh, no. I mean, we find those things all the time that are good to be challenged.
Yes, exactly.
So,
for sure.
So with the partner, we want to challenge that and to say that it's an equal partnership.
Yes. What I would love to see is that people are listening to this episode. Do what we did. Do your brain dump with your parenting partner. And if you don't have a parenting partner at home, it's like your single mom and kids. Right? Have your kids do it with you. Mm-hmm. Like, what do they expect as their job to do during the holidays? Or what do they think you're supposed to do during the holidays? I'm willing to bet those lists aren't going to be the same. Mm-mm. Between what you think you're supposed to do and what they think.
Oh, like, that would be interesting to see what my kids. That's one of the activities that we have in our challenge this year. Don't do the holidays alone is to sit down and see what everyone values in the holidays.
But there's a difference between what you value and what you think you're responsible to do.
There is. Right? So, like when you
I don't value wrapping gifts, but I think it's my job.
Yeah.
Or at least I did until last year.
And when you see like your kids value opening gifts, you're like, oh, they like this is important to them. So maybe I'll find a way to make this a little more doable or delegate it to someone else in the house.
Or you find that they don't like it. Like, instance, I have been hounding my son for the last 2 weeks to give some actual gifts that I can give to his grandmother to give to him because she's a very open, a present, a physical thing. Mm-hmm. And I was like, dude, I don't want anything like that. Like he's an experienced kid.
Yeah.
He'd rather be an experienced kid. So, I mean, yeah, I don't know where I was going with that.
It's
the
hard.
Train left the station and didn't come back.
I kind of get where it's going because it's a really complicated family dynamic where
I'm trying to make other people happy.
Trying to make other people happy, trying not to ruffle feathers and keep the family peace by going with this thing that has been gone on for a long time, but one person doesn't like enjoy it.
Has anybody said no?
No.
That's another example. Like no one has said this doesn't work.
This doesn't. Yeah. No one said it doesn't work because I'm guessing they don't want to upset, especially your mom who like puts all this work into the holidays.
Oh, she does.
And everything. They don't want to upset her. They don't want to disturb the family peace.
Yeah. Yeah. My parents always do this huge hoopla every year for Christmas and it's amazing. But honestly, the part that we remember the most, my siblings and I and the kids, is us all being together.
Yeah.
We could care less if we've got a 5-course meal. We could care less if there's like 20 gifts under the tree or 2 gifts under the tree. We just like getting to hang out.
And I think that's a really important thing to hear. And that sometimes those discussions can be difficult. But when you bring things like that in a family, I find that there is an initial period of challenge. I've done this in my family before. There's an initial period where everybody's mad at each other and like they don't talk. But you get the emotions cool down and then you talk and it becomes this new kind of normal where it's happier and where it's less stressful.
And the more you talk about things, the more open people are to doing those conversations again and again. Mm-hmm. We forgot to mention one of the big things we're telling you to let go of. So if the kids are listening in the car with you, like
mute it right now.
Yeah.
Mute it right now.
Okay. We're telling you, get rid of the elf on the shelf.
Get rid of the elf on the shelf.
That is not your job. And oh my gosh, I can't even count. Like, I did stuff for elves before there was elf on the shelf. And then all the stuff for Santa.
Oh my gosh, there's a lot.
Oh my God, there's so much. You can let that go.
It's funny because my husband actually is the one who does Elf on the Shelf. I don't do
it. He enjoys it?
He does. I think he enjoys like making the elf naughty.
You know, I was just thinking, people are going to get to hear my thought process here on air. I think that this year, because the advent calendar I'm torn about, it is a lot of activities to come up with to keep a lot of people happy because there's 5 people in the house. We have 2 teens, 1 young adult, plus my husband and I. And it's a lot of stress on me and I don't like it. Mm-hmm. I'm going to delegate that this year. I'm going to tell like each person they're responsible for 2 days on that calendar. And that's going to drastically cut down the stuff I have to do.
What if you didn't do the calendar?
I tried last year and they literally cried.
They literally cried?
So we'll do it again. I but I'll tell them, like, the only way we're doing it again is that everybody takes 2 days.
That's perfect. Gone. If it's distributed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that's how it's going to be.
I think that's a good idea.
All right. So stay tuned for a follow-up episode to let you know how that went.
We have a lot of follow-up. We have me giving experience gifts to everybody instead of giving real gifts.
And me, like, trying to, like, figure out, like, everybody doing stuff on the advent calendar.
Yes, so the advent calendar. And I consider cocktails as an experience. So,
oh my God.
I will give away cocktails.
I think that's phenomenal.
Yeah, I like making them. They're fun.
That makes me very happy.
Cocktails in a jar. It's what we do.
Cookies, food. Like, I like that kind of stuff. You get to a certain age and you're just like, I like getting to do stuff rather than have stuff.
Yep. It becomes too much stuff. And
it can be. It can be.
That's actually one way to manage ADHD is to make your environment uncluttered and get rid of stuff. And I think that's one of my coping mechanisms.
I think a lot of people have that coping mechanism. A lot of people do better with a clean environment. But okay, so hopefully we gave you guys some fantastic ways to stop comparing yourself to others, to let go of some of that holiday stress, to that toxic stuff that you hang on to that just weighs you down.
Toxic. I'm singing Britney Spears in my head as soon as Bree said the word toxic.
So, we have to do an episode where we just, like, randomly say things to each other to see what song pops into the other person's head.
Taste in my lips. Yeah. I can't even remember the words. I just see her with a snake. Remember, the best mom is a happy mom. Take care of you, and we will see you next time.
Thanks for stopping by.